Hey, so you guys want to know when you should start wearing over-the-counter reading glasses? Well, as an optometrist, I'm going to tell you what I tell all my patients. Stick around. All right, guys, so before we get started, if you like what I have to say, please smash the like button. If you are interested in seeing more of what I have to say, please consider subscribing. All right, let's get at it. So first of all, a couple things. If you're having significant symptoms, headaches, a lot of eye strain, things just don't seem right, please don't go guessing what you're going to use for over-the-counter reading glasses. Go get an eye exam. Your optometrist, if you will probably suggest a good pair of reading glasses, but even so, you can always ask him, you know, what should I use if I want to have a pair in the car, or, you know, a pair just in case I lose or don't have my other ones with me. And more than likely, they'll give you an idea of whether or not that would work. So again, if you're really symptomatic, please go get an eye exam. So let's talk about the reading glasses. So you're over 40, more than likely, or approaching it, and you go to pick something up and you're like holding it farther and farther away. Well, welcome. You have a condition called presbyopia. And presbyopia is when the lens inside our eye isn't focusing like it once did, and we need help. But I don't want you just running out and grabbing a pair of over-the-counter reading glasses. So first of all, I have to say, please, if you haven't had an eye exam, please go get one. It's a really important thing to do on a regular basis. Once 40 comes around, your risk of things like glaucoma, macular degeneration, even in your 40s, is possible. And it's a really good idea to get an eye exam. I'm going to give you a quick story. I had a patient a decade ago come to me complaining that he was bumping into walls and hitting doorways when he was going through. And he'd been buying over-the-counter readers for 10 years. He was in his early 50s. He had significant glaucoma and that vision was gone. And he was able to get away without having an eye exam by buying the over-the-counter reading glasses. So just please, get a good eye exam done periodically. With that, let's move on. So if you're just starting to notice, like you're a young parent and you go to pick up your kid's medicine bottle and you're like, oh man, it's so small, I can't get it close enough. Well, that's the beginning. But instead of running out and getting a pair of over-the-counter reading glasses, there's a couple things you can do. One is that when our pupils are smaller, our depth of focus is much longer. So if you have good lighting, walk to a window, you can probably pull that in a little bit closer and see it. That's one option. The other option, take your phone, take a picture of it, blow it up, boom. You'll be able to see it that way too. So those are a couple good options that people don't think about. You'll start noticing when you go to restaurants, and restaurants typically have poor lighting, that you'll see a guy sitting a table over from you and he's got his phone with the light on his phone blaring it into the menu, which I actually find really annoying. But it works, because what he's doing is putting enough light on that menu to make his pupils smaller so that he can bring it into that range that he needs to be able to see it at. So those are the cheats if you're starting to notice it, but at some point in time you're going to have to say, all right, I've had enough. I need to go at least have something with me for those times that it's getting to be tough. You know, so many of us spend so much time on our phones that it's just crazy. And some of the stuff that we look at is really, really small. So you made the decision. You're going to go buy the over-the-counter reading glasses. Which ones do you get? Well, here's what I want you to know. The powers start at a +1 and they go all the way up to a +4. In quarter increments. So +1, +1 and a quarter, +150, all the way up. please start with the plus ones, especially if you can find them. If you can't find them, I'm going to put a link down below to the ones on Amazon that I prefer. They also have the blue light blocking technology, but we'll get to that more towards the end. So I want you to start with plus ones and see if that works well. If it does, you're done. The higher the number you go to, the less you're going to be able to see without them in 4 or 5, 6 months. And it's true. I had a patient come in who automatically jumped to a plus two. He didn't need a plus two. He probably needed a plus one. But once he was in them for 6 or 7 months, he couldn't do anything without them because his eyes, the muscles in his eyes relax and they just do not want to work like they have. So please start with the lowest ones and then work your way up as you need to. All right, and then on the last point, I want you to think about finding an over-the-counter reading glass that has the blue light protection. Because we know the UV light does a lot of damage to the retina. Well, in the spectrum, the blue light is close to the UV light, the shorter waves, and those short waves have much more energy. So the damage that can be done with blue light is significant. What I'd like you to do, you can go on Amazon and take a look, and I put a link to a product down below on Amazon that has the reading glasses plus the blue light protection, and I think that's the best way to go. That's what I share with my patients, is just what I shared with you. I hope it helped. Please consider liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and until next time, take care.